Hi guys. In this video, we're going to be testing a bunch of stuff. So, first up is the E-Machines. Now, I've not even tested this yet myself, not off camera, I mean. So, this will be a first for me as well. So, it's all plugged in, all powered up. The monitor has come on and gone off. So, let's hit the power button, shall we? Dead. So that's our first fail. I've got a funny feeling that I know what's wrong, but we'll look into that in a minute. So we've got a motherboard to test, so I'm just going to get set up for that and I will be right back. Okay, I've just got to put this switch on and plug a few things into the back of the motherboard, but other than that, we are set up almost. Just got to go there. I don't even know if this power supply works. It came out of the other computer case, so that's what I'm suspecting with the computer, the E-Machines. I'm suspecting the power supply. So what we will do in a bit is I'll just temporarily hook up a power supply to that and test my theory. Or it could even be as simple as a broken button. And I really don't know what it is with this, but people seem to have just jammed shit in everywhere. Right, I'm gonna need a video card, I forgot about that. Whack the DVI adapter onto here. Like so. And plug this in. Like so. Plug that in. Like so. And in theory, we should be good to go if we have a red LED, so I know that power supply is good, but that's dead as well from the look of it. Got another power supply over there, but I don't think it's that. Power getting to the board, but nothing's working. Right, so that is all right. Let's just take that out. Sure, I've got that on the right one. Let me just grab my magnifier, double check that. Pretty certain I've got, oh, I had the switch on the correct one. Yeah. Right on that one. Keyboard light flickered. Right. Not having much luck at the minute, are we? flick that off for the minute. Take this out. And take that out. That's just my eyesight. Know what I might do? I might find a different switch and just try that. You never know. Start up, you bastard. Let's try it this way. There we go. Got a funny feeling, it's me switch. Look, oh, it's just turned itself off. I think I might just let me just go and get a switch out of my box and we'll try another one. Got another one. Because all I did was use a bit of wire and just short between the switch contacts. That's all I did. There we go. This switch works. So, that one's a dead switch. Get the Vidya card put back in. Now we'll see if it actually does anything. Oh, I ain't got a keyboard or mouse connected, so we might be a bit stuffed that way. Actually, before it boots, keep mouse's USB anyway, so. Whoa! We have life. The CPU might be a bit dodgy, it's came up with something. I'll zoom you in so you can see it. I don't know what sort of starts up, shuts down, and then starts up again. And now it's not going to do anything, is it? CPU is unworkable or has been changed. Please recheck CPU soft menu. Press F1, see what it does. It's doing something. Whether it continues to do something or not. Ooh. This one's got a broken SATA connector on it, so it's only got three usable ones. It's a 160GB hard drive, that one. It boots. Computer on a desk, it's a desktop, you see. Wrong way. It's literally a desktop computer. I wouldn't recommend using one like this. It's alright just for general testing, but... We'll see if that mouse works. This is the keyboard and mouse I got with all this lot as well. So, we've got a power supply we know works, we've got a motherboard we know works, we've got a hard drive we know works, and this works. Well, I found a switch that worked. But what I'm going to do, I'm just going to let this boot, shut it down. Only because I want to know what's on it. Actually, you know what, just to save a bit of time, I'm going to shut it off. And I can play around with that later, I think. I'm just going to unplug that. What I'm going to do now, I need this power supply to do a further test. So it's got a Molex connector down here, right next to the video slot, so I presume that's what that's for. Off. I'll take that switch off because I may need that in a bit. The mouse was lit up. That doesn't necessarily mean it works, but it was lit up. Right, that's for me to play around with later. If I haven't broken it first. I don't need this at the minute. I just want that. That is the cheapest, shittiest monitor I have ever had. But it works. Right. I want to test these to see what powers up and what doesn't. Get rid of the hard drive. Damn it, I've just lost my piece of wire. It was on this and I've just moved it and knocked it somewhere. Do with it. If not, it doesn't matter, I'll just get another bit. Supply of it behind me. Because if you want to get these power supplies to work, without the use of a computer motherboard, it's as simple as a piece of this. Unless you're happy to get earache off your dentist, don't use your teeth to strip wires. What you need to do is you get your 20 or your 24 pin connector. You find the contact, which has got your green wire, which is right in here. Poke your wire up there. And you simply just poke the other end on any one of the black. Like so, and it's powered up. Now I can actually switch it on and off using the switch at the rear. So I can now take our CD drive, plug in the connector, this is one for the bin, it's jammed, Sounds like it's actually trying to read a disc. Oh, there we go. It is. Sold out software. Imperial glory. This is the other reason. So is that working then? Is it? Oh. It is working. Okay. Hang on a minute. Oh, you are zoomed out. Zoomed out, rather. Okay. That's a pass. Lay it on me bin. Plug in the next one. I don't know if these actually read, but at least I know they power up. Same as this one. Sounds like we're struggling with this one as well. Open your bugger. Oh, there we go. Nope. That's a fail, that one. That's for the bin. I can't actually put anything in the bin yet because I ain't got no bags for the bin. Stand that in there. One pass, one fail so far. This might be a bit lengthy, this one, the video. I mean, right, there's another one. Green LED. That's got a disc in it as well. Microsoft works. But the drive itself seems to work, so. You son of a bitch. Till it decided to do that. There we go. So, two passes, one fail. Got two more to do. And I'll bring the computer back up on the bench. This is spinning it. This has got a disc in it as well. It's a CDR. That one's a pass. Three passes. One more. That works. That's that testing done. 4 out of 5 work. And we've got some discs here as well. That must be a game of some sort, Imperial Glory. No idea what's going to be on that, but it is scratched to shit. I don't know if that's going to show up. And Microsoft works. Pardon me. For distribution with a new PC computer, system component or computer accessory. Right. Up we go. Whew. Well, as they say, test the obvious first. So I'm going to pull the switch off. That's hard drive LED. Fuck. They've put the header on round the other way on this one. Assholes. Can we try that again? I'm not going to plug the monitor or anything in. I just want to know if it's going to power up. Let's actually get the LEDs off out of the way as well, because I don't need those to test it, do I? If it doesn't do anything with a new switch, then I'll try the power supply. Nope, we're still dead. It's still dead, Jim. So, the power button is not our problem. funny feeling it's going to be the power supply. And we have got a 24 pin connector. Right, so I'll show you what I'm going to do. Tilt that up. So I'm going to find out if it's the power supply. I'm going to pull this off out of the way. So we can access the 24 pin power connector, because I don't need anything else at this precise moment. I'm going to leave my dangly switch on for the minute, just because it's easier. We'll bring in this power supply because we know this one works. All I'm going to do is struggle to see what the hell I'm doing. Plug this one into the board, like so. Oh, the 12 volt ones are right to get to. Plug in all I need to do, just to test, plug in the power supply, switch on, told you that's what it would be. Well, there we go, we've got our diagnosis. Power supply is dead. Diagnosis, Dark. We have a defunct power supply. There we go. I knew it was going to be one or the other. It's probably why they stopped using it, because it stopped working. They just went out and bought another one, as some people do, instead of getting them fixed. When an ATX power supply like that wouldn't have cost a great deal. Unless their thoughts were, you know, they've had it for such a length of time, they just want to get something different. But, who knows? Right. Let's see if this boot, I'm going to turn you off for this, because I've got to change all that power supply and whatnot, so I'll be back in a bit. Okay, moment of truth. The power supply is in, everything is connected up. Helps to turn the power supply on. Right. I've got a green LED on this time, so. Okay, so what I'm going to do, could be the switch as well. Where's my torch? That was a good test, wasn't it? Fail. Dodgy switch on it as well. Right. Is that? Oh. That's the rear fan, by the way. And the Windows XP. I know the other power supply was dead because I tried this switch on that power supply and it didn't work, as you saw. The bearings are gone on that fan. Yeah, because it's in there nice and tight. nothing from the mouse yet, so that might actually be a dud one. It's got AVG on it. It's got a performance monitor on it. While that's doing that, I'm just going to grab another mouse, just in case. If I get past you without knocking you over. Got my Alba one here. That one really does not want to work. That one's working. Oh, this one is working. They both work now. Chuck that one over there. Yeah, what? It's taking forever to boot. Holy crap. AOL 9.1. Yes, I am using the mouse left-handed. I'm glad that fan has just shut up. Anyone fancy a cup of tea while we wait? Heck, is that the time? Isn't it 7:45? No wonder I'm feeling a little hungry. So I've got C. I've got to change the switch on this. An error occurred while we tried to connect you to AOL service. Well, duh. I actually feel like dragging an Ethernet cable over here to see if that would actually fix it. I'll do that later, though. I'm not going to do that right now. Oh, bugger off! Just doing all sorts of weird, wonderful shit. Cancel that. Close that fucking error. Cancel. You are starting to piss me off now. trying to sign in automatically, that's what it's trying to do. I forgot this was here. I don't think the other end is plugged in though. That's alright, because I'll soon plug it in. Right, I'll just go check the other end, because that is really bugging me now. If I can find the other end. I've got it, let's plug it in. Crap, I just hit a button. I don't know what button I hit, but I hit a button. Right. Well, it's connecting to the internet now. Well, it seems to have stopped. Ah, it's Messenger that keeps wanting to start. Does that even exist anymore? I'll certainly shut up after I plugged that internet in. There's games on it. What programs have we got? Burn CD or data DVD, Big Fix, AOL, Adobe accessories, Microsoft Money, Microsoft Works, Power DVD, QuickTime, Real Player, Startup, Internet Explorer, Netscape, System Gear, PopCap Games. Okay, let's go to Control Panel then. See what else is installed on it. Adobe Reader, Advanced System Gear, AOL Broadband Toolbar, AOL and installer, AOL You've Got Pictures screensaver, AVG 2014, that's a good couple of years out of date then. Bejeweled, Digital Media Reader, not connected at the minute, Download Updater, Driver Booster, IOBit, whatever that is, Java, Microsoft Money, blah 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 blah, Nero Burn Rights, Nero OEM, Peggle, Power DVD, QuickTime, Got a replaced power supply. Replace the switch, I hope. Shut this down. Well, the internal battery's good. Because the clock on there said 7:54 and it is actually 7:54 by my clock on the wall. Right, that is it for this video. We have tested everything. We have got this machine working. I've just got to put in a new switch. I'm going to figure out how to just pop the front of this off. Oh, just like that, I think. Yeah, just like that. And that's one thing I don't actually understand. What dumbass. The switch wasn't working. Because I've plugged the wrong fucking wire onto the switch bit. Nothing wrong with the switch. I just had the wrong wire plugged on it. That's hard drive LED. That goes at the top. Blue one is power LED, yes? Yes. That's the one I was plugging in as power switch. So, in theory, since I've just got this wire plugged back on here, I'll just show you what I'm doing. I thought the blue one here, I don't know if you can quite see that. I thought this blue one was the power switch. It's not, it's the black one. Oops. That's why it wasn't turning on when I was pressing the button. There's nothing wrong with the switch at all. What was wrong with it was the person that was pushing the button. That's what was wrong with it. Right. LED hard drive. I'm just going to turn this on once more. With the button. Oh, there we go. Button works now. Whoops. I don't think the hard drive likes me doing that. I forgot the hard drive is right with my finger. What's the case? There, because I'm zoomed in too much. Oops, I think I might have broke the might have broke it now. Oh, no. Oh, I didn't realise. Again, user error. Of course it's not going to boot unless I connect the hard drive. I didn't even know that popped off. Didn't even see it pop off. There we go. Had to make yourself look like a total tit in one lesson. There we go. In that case, you missed the side panel. You can go back on this one. Because it's a working machine. So, we have tested. We have one working. I think someone may have swapped this power supply out in the past. I can hear it loading, but because when I took the old one out, There was only three screws holding it in, which was a kind of a giveaway that someone had been playing with it. Maybe someone tried to have a look at it and couldn't figure out what was wrong with it. So I'm just going to put a screw in there. And two in the side cover. Pardon me, a side cover. Your computer might be at risk. But how many years out of date is it? 14, 15, 3 years out of date. One more. Whack the screw in and then I'll end the video, methinks. I might, at the very least, go and get a drink because I'm getting a bit thirsty. But despite having the lounge window open, I'm getting a bit sweaty as well. There we go, we're all back together, it's all working. All is fine and dandy. Not anymore, it's not. Local network cable is unplugged. See, that's why I hate it when the clips fall off. Maybe the account doesn't exist anymore. Oh, hello. There's a guest one. Not a guest one. Maybe AIM doesn't exist anymore. Who knows? I don't. Shut down then, we're done. I've had enough for now. So, sorry, just lost the plot there for a second. Thanks a lot for watching. And as always, if you liked the video, give me a thumbs up. If you didn't, give me a thumbs down. And I will talk to you again in the next video. Bye.